96.7 FM, WORX. Hello, and thank you for tuning back in. It is 9:04 a.m., and it is the first Tuesday in the month of June. That means it's time once again for Veterans Talk. Veterans Talk brought to you by Farmers Bank of Milton. AJ Bramer here in the studio, and I'm joined, as always, by State District Service Officer Joe DeVito. Joe, as always, good to see you.
Good morning, AJ.
And we're also joined by Jefferson County Veteran Service Officer Faith Weir. Hello again, Faith.
Good morning.
So, we always appreciate this chance to check in with the two of you, talk about different things that are going on and different things that are available for our area veterans.
Absolutely. Appreciate you having us here. Want to start off, we missed a show. That we will be making up, but I do want to let everybody know out there listening that the main gist of us being here, the main gist of you guys helping us with this radio show is to get our veterans in the area to know that we have a county veteran service officer right here in Jefferson County. We actually have one in every county in the state. So what our main goal is to get veterans to get down to those service offices and see what's available to them. Their county veteran service officer is their expert in state benefits and federal benefits. And there's a lot of benefits out there that the state offers and the federal government. And there's even some for dependents of veterans. So we really want them to go and find out. You can look at the websites. You can read some of the pamphlets and booklets and learn the general idea of benefits. But it's truly individual to each benefit or each veteran. So it's important for them to get their discharge papers if you got them. If you don't, Faith can help you get them. And get down there and see specifically for you, your family, your situation, your era of service, all the different things, what might work just for you. Far more times than not, right, Faith, folks will come in either by encouragement from somebody or looking for a specific question and wind up leaving with a whole lot of benefits that they had no idea were available. So that's what we're looking to do is get that word out, get folks, get down to that office, see your veteran service officer for your county and find out what's going on and what you can start doing to look into benefits and other programs that are out there.
I think it's something we say all the time on this show that, you know, a lot of times that information when you're going through all that it can be pretty overwhelming. So having somebody there to work through it with you is a huge benefit. But more importantly, a lot of times you will go in looking for one thing and you'll come out with a bunch of other information that you had no idea you even qualified for.
Absolutely. Exactly. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yep. And even just to get in our system, we've got a standardized system that we all use. So there may not be certain things available to you right now, but down the road there will be, and to be in the system it makes it that much easier. So get in there and get the system, see what's available to you. And you know, it is governmental paperwork, so it's a little confusing and a little overwhelming at its first appearance, but you know, Faith is she's an expert at making that simple, like you said. So what seems intimidating or overwhelming to apply for benefits or to gather material is super simplified by your county service officer. She can help you figure out what to do, give you plain lists, and make it easy for you. So it's just so important to get down there. So any veteran out there or the relative or friend of a veteran, you know, if you haven't been to your county service officer within the last 12 months or so, get an appointment, get down there, have a quick discussion, see what's available.
Definitely want people to make that office visit and make that phone call for sure.
Absolutely.
I know the last time, Faith, we had you on the program, we talked about the upcoming stand down.
Yep.
And we're definitely looking forward to that.
Yep. The stand down is going to be September 14th from 11 to 1:30 at the Brown Gym. This year, we're going to be honoring our Vietnam veterans. So we're encouraging them to bring a picture of themselves either in uniform or as they are now.
We're both.
We're going to have honor walls displaying them. We're also going to have a roll call. We just are encouraging all of our veterans to come out to the stand down. There's going to be a lot of folks out there with tables with information for our veterans. There's going to be a free lunch. We're going to have special gift bags made up for our Vietnam veterans and gift bags for our other veterans that attend. It's just really beneficial. There's a lot of information, a lot of folks there that are going to have information that they might not be aware of. And it's just a really good time. So we're encouraging all of our veterans to show up September 14th at the Brown Gym. Starts at 11 and gets over at about 11 or 1:30.
Right on. And that's one of the great things about this event that Faith's been working so hard on, and Sue as well.
Oh, yes.
Is, you know, the goal is to not just have information, but they're going to have some specific services available, too, for veterans. And I know we're going to have folks from Rob Lee Rex VA Medical Center yep. will be there. So I know we'll be able to probably do on-spot enrollment in VA healthcare.
Yes.
I'll be there with the Indiana Department of Veterans Affairs, and between us and Faith at our table, we'll be able to, she'll be busy probably running around, but I'll be able to,
yes.
we'll be able to approve state benefits right there as well. So we'll be able to, you know, get veterans into the system, approve, stamp, get them out the door with benefits available to them, approved on the spot. So that's kind of the goal. And there's a bunch of different services coming. So it's really worthwhile if you're a veteran, you want to just kind of see what's going on. If you are you're a veteran who needs services, or you think you're at risk in some way, shape, or form, it's definitely a great place to go, or encourage a veteran you know in that situation to come on down, or just come and get information for them. Either way. And really, anybody who's a veteran, come on down. Is there lunch this year?
Absolutely.
All right.
There's going to be lunch. So if nothing else, come and get a free meal. And really, the stand down is designed for those veterans in crisis and need. And we've opened it up and to try and encourage more veterans to come out. I think our county is very fortunate in the fact that, at least that I'm aware of, we do not have a lot of homeless veterans. So we are fortunate. And that's why we've kind of really opened it up a lot more to just encouraging any and all veterans to attend. But most certainly, if there's a veteran in crisis or a veteran in need, absolutely get them over there. There's going to be a lot of different folks. Like Joe said, there's going to be some people from the VA there. And so we absolutely want to make sure that they get enrolled in VA healthcare. And if there's any other needs that need to be met, we can work with them on that.
Definitely a great opportunity for folks to get information, but also a great opportunity to, you know, honor area veterans, specifically the veterans of Vietnam. Definitely
yep.
a very cool event that we've definitely seen grow quite a bit the last several years.
Absolutely, yeah. It's getting bigger and better every year, and that's really a testament to Faith's leadership at the office and her vision for the office. You know, I mentioned earlier, I want to throw in real quick, you know, the job description. I help support 15 county service officers in Southeast Indiana. The state of Indiana is 6 districts, and I'm there to basically help each of them with training for them, for their staff, and support them in any way I can via the state to help them do their job better. And the job description is to be a benefits expert, interact with their area veterans, help them understand benefits, and if they identify some, help them put together the packages right, fill out all the paperwork correctly, get it sent to the right spot. And that's the basic job. But, you know, we've got, thank God, in Indiana a handful, and we're growing by the day, of county veteran service officers like Faith who see beyond what that job is. And, you know, if you haven't been down, go. She's got some great boards up in there with, I think we got, what, World War II, Korea.
From
in
last
Vietnam.
Year's
She's got pictures of the veterans up there. It's very personable. There's always candy, there's coffee, and she does these events like the stand down and other things, and she really goes far beyond what her job is to really help our community understand benefits, understand what's there, and there's a camaraderie too for veterans to show up at things like the stand down and just kind of shoot the breeze and trade stories and get to know each other a little better and a little differently. So please, if you're a veteran out there, or a friend of a veteran, not only get to the office, but check out the stand down as well.
And the dates for the stand down again?
September 14th at the Brown Gym from 11 to 1:30.
Joey, talk about a lot of different things that go on with veterans in our community. Obviously, you know, we know that the Veterans Service Offices goes above and beyond the folks there, you know, to help our area veterans. But we are also fortunate in our area that we have a very active Veterans Council.
Absolutely. And, you know, I want to give a quick acknowledgement to my predecessor before I was the Jefferson County Veterans Service Officer, Dick Jones. Dick was a really good service officer, and he was a founding member of the Jefferson County Veterans Council. So him and a few folks back in the day, probably 20 years ago, I would say, or maybe a little longer, kind of formulated the Veterans Council. And what it really is it's a nonprofit organization comprised of different members of the community in veteran organizations and groups like the VFW, the Legion, the County Veteran Service Officer, and then other veterans or folks who want to kind of be involved with it. And the main goal at this point, what has kind of rolled into, is two missions. One mission is to provide drivers and the and running of the transportation system that we have with the DAV/VA van. And the other thing is they come up with other ways to support the community, the veteran community. And, you know, one of the projects I'm proud to be a member as well that we worked on was getting the new memorial on the courthouse lawn. And, you know, Faith especially and Robin Henderson played a key role in the veterans banner program that we see around town now with the veterans pictures and banners all over there. And they worked real hard with, was it Happy over at Madison, was it Main Street? They worked real hard with some other folks to get that going. And that's kind of what that group does. And, you know, I think it's great to give them acknowledgement, too, for what they're doing with our veterans community. And a great way to do it would be at the Regatta Parade this year.
Yep.
Come out and give them a wave. There's a float,
yep.
Right?
Jefferson County Veterans Council is going to have a float in the parade this year. We had a float last year, but this year we're going to have folks who are going to be walking behind the float with candy for the kids.
All right.
That was one of the things that we were kind of disappointed we didn't do last year. So this year we'll have candy for the kids. And it's just a way for folks to be able to see us and to... See our veterans. One other thing is any veterans that would like to ride on the float and represent their branch of the military service, don't hesitate to call my office at 812-265-3600. We're encouraging all veterans to get on the float and represent their right branch of the service, and right. It's
or walk behind.
Right. It's just a really good way for folks to see the veterans out and about, and you know, a good way of honoring. It was really touching. Last year was my first year, and I think a little overwhelmed with the amount of people that were cheering our veterans on, and I think it was a really good thing for our veterans. So we're encouraging any veterans that would like to participate and ride on the float to give my office a call, and we'll get you on there.
All right.
That's a very cool way to honor our veterans, you know, having them in the parade.
It is, and support the group as well. And on that note, like I said, one of the main purposes of the council is to coordinate some transportation for veterans. And that's transportation for veterans who need to get to VA medical appointments but have an issue with transportation and can't get there. So we've got this great vehicle that you've probably seen around town with the DAV logos on it, and that's a program where the DAV and the VA work together with an organization, in this case our Veterans Council, to help provide that transportation. And you know, that program can't work without somebody to drive that vehicle. And those volunteer drivers are always needed. And it's a one way that if you're out there and you think you want to kind of help veterans out in our local community and, you know, do something positive for veterans, and if you want to, you know, literally affect folks in your neighborhood, veterans right here at home, one great way to do that is to volunteer and help drive. You don't have to get stuck in a rigid schedule. If you can do one day a month, I'm sure they'll help you get on board and do that one day a month. So,
yes.
You know, you can give Faith's office a call, 812-265-3600. She can point you in the right direction to Dave Adams, who's our transportation coordinator, and
yes,
works tirelessly to make sure the drivers are lined up and all the riders are picked up in certain locations and to make sure everybody gets to their appointments on time. And it's a job, it's a hard job to do. And the drivers are just the most important thing. So once again, if you want to volunteer to help drive, it takes a little bit of effort up front to get a quick physical, I think, from the VA. Mm-hmm. Nothing big. And then once you're approved, you can get on that list of drivers and really, you know, positively affect our veterans in a great way right here in our county.
Yes.
Yeah, it's a great way to give back, and it's a really easy way to give back. You know, you guys are providing the gas in the vehicle.
All you got to do is drive.
Yep.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yep. And you get a great parking spot,
yes,
I think, when you're there. And they have, and at the hospital, I know when you go to veterans to the Rob Lee Rex Medical Center, there's a special parking lot just for these spots, these vans. And I think they got services up there. They got a lounge area, I think, for the drivers and a place to go in and relax and meet some other drivers. And so it's just a really great thing that you can do to help out our community of veterans.
You know, obviously getting them to those appointments is very important. Another thing, I know we are working on something on the local level to connect our veterans to their doctors as well.
Yes.
Over at the Veteran Service Office.
Another service our office is looking into providing for our veterans is the VA Virtual Video Connect. And what that program is we're going to have hoping to have a safe and secure spot where you can come in, get on a tablet or a computer, and connect with your doctor. So instead of having to travel to one of the VA clinics or the VA hospital in Louisville and come into our office, there's going to be a space there where you can get online and talk to your doctor. It's great for follow-up appointments, minor things that don't require any kind of specialized testing or anything, and it'll save you some travel time. So that's not going to be, we're trying to get that in the works. Hopefully in the next few months we'll have that up and going, and we'll keep everyone updated on that. But it's, like I said, it's just one more service that our office is trying to provide for our veterans to maybe cut down on some of that travel time, where, like I said, with follow-up appointments where you're there for a half an hour, you see the doctor for 30 seconds and you're on your way home. So instead of having to travel all the way in there, you can come into the office, connect with your doctor, even simple things. You've got a cold and you don't necessarily need to go in. It's little things like that. But again, we're in the works with that with the VA, and we're really excited about this program.
Yeah, it's a great program. And while we're talking about VA healthcare really quick, the VA provides what they call community-based outpatient clinics. That's like a doctor's office for a veteran. We have them in Scottsburg, New Albany, and Carrollton, Kentucky. I did want to mention that Carrollton, Kentucky clinic, which is actually the closest one to Madison,
yes,
by mileage and drive time, is actively seeking patients. So any veterans in the area, if you're in VA healthcare, you're in the system, or you're going to get in the system, you can always go to the Carroll Clinic if you're going to Scottsburg, which is pretty full at the moment.
Yes.
And then New Albany built a brand new facility, which created some openings, and now it's getting pretty full too. So the Carroll County Clinic is open for business. They're fully staffed with support staff, nurses, and also doctors. And I can attest as a patient to the Carroll County Clinic that if you get there early, you're getting in early. It is just efficient, it's fast. Like I said, they're fully staffed and they're actively looking for veterans to enroll and utilize that clinic. So anybody out there who's maybe had a couple timetable issues or is just looking to make sure they have something quick and easy, it's a quick shot across the bridge, and they're actively seeking folks. So I wanted to get that word out there to anybody who's looking for a different clinic or might want to switch over there, that they're ready for them.
Different things are available for our area veterans. Always appreciate an opportunity to talk with the two of you, and definitely appreciate the work that you do for our area veterans.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
So one thing I want to mention really quick is possibly a quick apology to our area veterans, because as the state of Indiana, as an organization, we are taking your county veteran service officers next week. So that would be the 10th, 11th, and 12th, mm-hmm, is our annual conference that we have every year at Camp Atterbury. It's a mandatory conference for all 92 county veteran service officers to come to as a part of our accreditation process. So the Indiana Department of Veterans Affairs, we went through the steps to become an accrediting body, which helps to move our service officers through training and get into accreditation. So it's a mandatory training that we have to have, mm-hmm, annually. So on those days, I think, will you have the office covered with,
yep,
Sue?
Sue will be in the office manning the phones, and any folks that come in and just want to schedule an appointment. And Sue is also, she's amazing, and she's wonderful with our veterans. And if you're you need to order a copy of your DD-214, she can help you with that. If you're needing an appointment to get in to see me, she can help you with that. So she's just wonderful. And so the office will be open while I'm gone, and Sue will be there, like I said, handling the phones and manning any walk-ins that come in. So.
Well, that's great. So, and just for folks, and I know we cover more than Jefferson County with the airwaves here, so just be patient with us next week. If you have something coming up, maybe make sure you get to your county service officer this week, kind of get it squared away a little bit, make sure you know that we're going to have that small break for them to come up and do our annual training. And really, the last thing I want to hit on is today is my lovely wife's birthday. So I wanted to say happy birthday to her. And that's about it.
Well, we definitely appreciate you coming on the program. Faith, anything else you'd like to add before we wrap up?
Nope, just encouraging our veterans to come into the office or give us a call at 812-265-3600. Especially if you don't know what benefits are available to you, or if you know what benefits are available to you and you're needing some help, we're just encouraging all of our veterans to come in, see us, and
absolutely.
Sit down. And
you just don't know till exactly. You go there with your mm-hmm. stuff and sit down. And the address is 315 Jefferson, right?
Yep, in the courthouse annex building.
The old Eagles building. That's what everybody refers to it as.
And it's about the easiest office visit or phone call you're ever going to make.
It yes. sure is.
Excellent.
It can't hurt.
Faith Weir, Joe DeVito, thank you guys so much for coming on the program.
Thank you so much.
Again, that is State District Service Officer Joe DeVito and Jefferson County Veteran Service Officer Faith Weir. They're joining us once again for Veterans Talk.